Is it just comfort or gratitude? I welcome you all with my love and respects and the blessings of my Guru, His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan, Shri Nithyananda, Paramashiva. I want to share with you a click I got recently about the proper space to relate to Guru. At least that's the latest cognitive shift I got about that. And I got it while I was contemplating and listening to the satsangs that Swamiji is giving recently on Nithyananda TV, inviting you to check it as well. And he's talking about basically creating your future consciously and not just an accident. And what I realized is that sometimes, and what I related to is that Swamiji said that the love that we know is actually quite cheap. It is not a real love. And we have to shift from that cheap love to the real love. And the guru-disciple relationship allows that shift to happen. And the click I got is basically that sometimes in our life, when we do not realize that we are creating the reality we experience, when it doesn't click with us, and we feel and we generate a lot of powerlessness in front of various situations that we encounter in the day-to-day life, sometimes we just go back home and then go to the Guru's feet and just feel like, oh, Swamiji, Swamiji, I love you, I love you, I love you. Definitely it is a feeling connection and it has its place, but what I realized is that that feeling connection has to grow to the point where you create, you manifest your reality consciously. It should not be a kind of a feel-good feeling. It should not just be a feel-good feeling to compensate for the powerlessness that you experience, but it should be a powerful reminder of the space of Paramashivoham so that we realize, we become aware of the reality we are manifesting for ourselves and start to create the reality we want consciously. And when we relate to the Guru, to Swamiji, it should be out of gratitude because, oh my God, I manifested my reality. This is amazing. And I'm so grateful for you, to you, Swamiji, because you have shown me the path or given me the right understanding or the right experience or whatever, the right intuition or the right powers to manifest what I want. So the love should evolve from from this comforting kind of zone that we feel with Swamiji to a space of gratitude because we have manifested Swamiji's teachings in our life. And that is the real gratitude. That is a real space where you feel powerful and not, hiding away or shying away from the problems we face in our daily life and in front of which we manifest powerlessness, but instead using that as a space to ferociously engage with life, realize how we are responsible for the life that is happening in front of us and changing it if we want to change it so that we can create our life consciously. And like that, the connection with the Guru grows and grows in maturity. And the connection, the depth of love becomes more and more mature. So that's a powerful click I got recently because definitely sometimes when we feel powerless, we just kind of take refuge. There's always this easy example, kind of popular, I guess, in the, you can hear it a lot in normal life or in the daily life. People will say like when a girl goes through emotional ups and downs, they will go and get an ice cream. Like Swamiji should not be an ice cream for us. It should not be just, oh, because I'm experiencing bitterness everywhere in my life, I go and experience a sweetness with Swamiji and then somehow my life balances and I'm just constantly jumping from bitter to sweet, bitter to sweet, bitter to sweet. No, it is really about, going, of course, connecting with Swamiji, experiencing the sweetness, but from that space, you know, getting the Shaktipada happening, the transfer, allowing Swamiji's space to manifest through us so that we manifest our life consciously and we do not experience bitterness in our everyday situation and life. So that's the click I got, I wanted to share. Tell me what you think below. Inviting you to like, to subscribe, click the bell icon. Thanking you again for watching these videos And yes, again, wanted to bring forward that if you feel empowered or enriched by these videos, please feel free to write mark of appreciation down below. It is always good to see how we impact people around us when we enrich, when we conduct enriching activities. And also inviting you to check the links down below, the latest song, Tamil traditional song, Paattum Naane, a song about Lord Shiva, and the video about the Pada Puja, Paduka Puja. I released a video recently for beginners who want to understand the context and be guided in the experience of the Pratyeksha Paduka Puja. Feel free to check the links down below. With this, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you again. Nithyananda.